So let's talk about money, media, air rights. Verizon extends its deal with the NFL for 4 more years, $250 million a year. What does that mean to Verizon? What can they do?
Well, it's pretty interesting. I mean, if you just look at it from the NFL standpoint, they're really the only ones that have actually sliced the cake this way. And, you know, they've done something pretty unique here. I mean, the rest of the world is looking at TV everywhere deals, and they actually are offering exclusivity to Verizon for smartphone usage. And so what they effectively did was, if you look at the old deal and the new deal, they added about another $70 or $80 million a year. And you could look at it as they sold content rights for about that much on smartphones alone. Pretty interesting.
So the NFL is basically selling their rights by device, really, the way in which you access their content. Whereas if you look at Major League Baseball, the NBA, or the NHL, the TV everywhere model is you go to one provider and they give it to you on all your devices?
That's correct. Yeah, and it's not just sports. It's essentially all the buyers and sellers of content and distribution are valuing TV everywhere as a response to viewer demand and viewers wanting access to whatever it is they want, whenever they want it.
And so for Verizon, it's live streaming, this next deal, of all the games, not just exclusive games or specific games.
Yeah, that's correct, on smartphones. So they have access to the Sunday games and then the Thursday packages as well as the Sunday night games.
So what is the NFL strategy with this? Why are they doing it this way?
Well, you know, it's interesting. It's a four-year deal, right? So my sense is that they're going to take a look and see how it all works. I'm sure their network partners, right, weren't thrilled, right, because although the flip side of that argument is would anybody really leave a big TV screen in return for a small little smartphone screen? So I'm not sure it's really going to affect the ratings. They'll see how it all works in 4 years, and you know, maybe they'll get a better look at how many subscribers Verizon got to their NFL mobile app, and they'll be able to kind of assess what it looks like 4 years from now.
Yeah, and if you're one of the networks, CBS, Fox, or NBC, you can't be surprised that this happened, really, right? Because you knew in your contract terms that the league had the right to do this.
Oh, yeah.
And the league obviously is trying to maximize revenue, so they're getting a 40% increase with this deal. What does this say, though, to the power of the NFL brand? Because I'm thinking, you know, I read a quote where an executive at Fox said, yeah, I called up the NFL when I saw this because now every game's going to be on. And he said, the NFL just said, well, how are your ratings? You know, because it's still the best ratings of any sport.
Yeah. Well, it just shows you the power of the NFL brand. I mean, it is an incredible brand, and they're in a position of leverage to be able to essentially go against the grain of the business model, which is TV everywhere, in the entire ecosystem and carve out a different way of doing it. So it's an incredibly powerful brand.
Guys, I'm trying to look at this from a viewer standpoint. Chris, I totally agree. I don't really want to watch a game on my smartphone. Maybe if I need to, or I'm thinking in terms of second screen technology. I'm watching on my big screen, but maybe I'm keeping track of a game here too.
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a bit of that, and then you have all the other interactive elements like social networking, be able to talk to your friends while you're watching, which is all sort of occurring, you know, around live sports in general. But here, I mean, you've got it. This is exclusive to a device, right? So what it's going to do, and, you know, I think Olympics data showed you that it's not going to cannibalize viewership on the big screen. Rather, it's going to it's going to allow more people that might not have access to a TV at wherever place and time they are. It just allows for more portability of the content, which I think is a good thing.
Sprint used to have this deal. Verizon took it from them and now is re-upping. And it's very interesting. They don't have a pricing plan out yet, but I've seen some numbers where they're talking about maybe being $5. Is that enough for this to make economic sense for Verizon?
Well, sure it is. I mean, I think if you think of it this way, what does ESPN charge?
It just so happens to be about
$5 a month, right?
Per subscriber per month.
And you can pretty quickly get to some pretty attractive math here. If it's $5 a month times 12 months a year, how many subscribers do you really need to break even on what we talked earlier was a $70 or $80 million increase from the last deal? I mean, you can just run the math on that, and it's a very attractive proposition if it's sold in properly.
Are they sort of like throwing the line out too, guys? You know, because we all have carrier services at home where we like to bundle. Is this a way for them to get you to buy a lot of other services as well?
Yeah, no, I think that's exactly right. I mean, I brought a little prop with me here. I got my I'm a Verizon customer, right? And I actually have a Verizon Fios TV service. I have their broadband service. I have their phone service. So, you know, I got a 13-page bill here, okay? that adds up to a lot of money every month. And I have a very deep customer relationship with Verizon. And so here's something, another $5 on top of that, in order to get live games on my smartphone, you know, I might do that.
You know, the other thing I'm thinking, too, is if you have every sort of device there, at home, internet, your cell phones are on there, do you really want to, as a consumer, go out and shop and look for something else at another provider? Or, you know what I mean?
That's
a pain right now.
That's right. It's a great marketing tool, too. And you're by the way, you've aligned with the most powerful brand in all of sports. So Verizon, NFL, I mean, you could do a lot around that. And so I suspect that this will end up being a great deal for Verizon. And the NFL, if it's really a great deal for Verizon, at the end of 4 years, we'll have a chance to see what the economics look like.
What about protecting Verizon, this deal protecting Verizon in terms of usage fees? You know, right now they have this thing, net neutrality, which is basically you don't have to pay for your product being on the internet more than somebody else. But that may not last, right? So if the NFL knows that really people are going through Verizon because of their premium products, does this protect Verizon if you ever totally leave net neutrality and have to pay a premium for usage?
I think you're hitting right on the whole idea around usage-based pricing, right? That's how the telephone business started, and eventually, you know, made long-distance calls. You paid more than if you didn't, right? So right now, it's very interesting. I mean, what does Verizon do, right? They spend billions of dollars a year on upgrading their transport system so that they can get customers like you and I to buy more stuff and use more bandwidth. Right, at some point, you want to move to a usage-based pricing model. And so, you know, what better way to get there than watch live three-hour NFL football games in high definition on your device? You're going to start using more bandwidth. And it stands to reason that they should be able to charge customers that use more bandwidth more than those that don't.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you have a big enough bill right now. If you're a consumer, but you love those NFL games, you don't want to pay that much extra to watch 2, 3, 4 games a week?
I mean, we'll see. That's why I think you're going to get into the market. But so far, right, the answer has been in the last technological iteration of this was NFL Sunday Ticket that DirecTV bought. And here they are several years later with 3 million customers paying them a pretty good premium every year.
Is technology evolving enough to keep up with this?
Right, that's my other prop here.
I'm feeding right into his prompts.
Here's my iPad, right? I mean, I watch. So it's a portable television, right? So the consumer just wants access to whatever it is he or she wants, whenever they want it, on whatever device they want it. And that should be seamless to them without having to deal with all the rights issues. And that's hence the TV everywhere approach by the cable industry, right? So I think ultimately what's going to happen is you're going to have your cable subscription in your pocket, walking around with it wherever you go. Right?
Would that be the same at home?
Like
maybe an app on your TV where you don't even need all the boxes and everything else
that we have around the house. I mean, you know, do you really need a box and can it all come out of the cloud? I mean, technology's there to do that. Yeah.
And, you know, it's interesting. People may sometimes say, well, wow, Verizon's going to pay 40% more. But if you look at the performance of Verizon stock since they got the NFL and it left Sprint, Verizon stock has outperformed Sprint stock by like 2-1. So it's really paid off just in the way, you know, you look at DirecTV has totally outperformed its competitors.
That's right. I mean, all these media companies, whether you're on the content or the distribution side, just go back and look. I mean, it's record profitability, you know, record stock prices. This is a great time to be in the media business and own or have intellectual property rights like the NFL.